What you see on the screen here is the DODL lesson plan that my group members and I created. Our grade level was third grade. As you can see here, our content standard was 3.5, which states students demonstrate basic economic reasoning skills and an understanding of the economy of the local region. The substandard is describe the ways in which local producers have used and are using natural resources, human resources, and capital resources to produce goods and services in the past and in the present. So with that, we created our learning objective, which is HSS 3.5.1, which states, scholars would describe how locals use and are using resources to produce goods through Google searches, outlines, and diagrams with three or more examples. So here is our level of Bloom's taxonomy, which we chose understand because in our content standard, right here where I'm scrolling over, it has to understanding. And that's why we chose level of Bloom's taxonomy. My favorite part of the lesson was exploration. Let me get to that part here. There we go. So I love this part of the lesson because of the Jamboard itself. The Jamboard was a creative idea so that the students can design their own houses. The reason why we chose designing their houses is because the students will need to know what type of materials goes into to building a house. While they were creating their houses or designing their houses, they had to jot down what type of materials they needed to build their houses. This allowed students to explore the type of resources we were going to teach or going to explain later on in the lesson, like I stated earlier, which is human, capital, and natural resources. So that happens. When students were creating their homes, we as the teachers were able to see their creations and see the list of materials they used. With that list of materials, we were able to connect it back to our explanation, which materials they used from our bricks, wood, and windows. And that definitely connects back to the resources that we were going to teach later on. This activity allowed students to think freely within the limits of the activity. So that connects back to the component that we needed for the exploration. It connected it back to the table, the BSCS 5E instructional model, what the student does. And so that's why I really liked that part of the lesson, because we tied it and we completed that part of the lesson, which thinks freely within the limits of the activity, what the student does.